Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to MLG Clubhouse. I'm joined by the wonderful Maven. We're going to soothe your ears.
Soothe them. A sweet lullaby.
It's worth mentioning our predictions. We're getting a little bit competitive now between me and you.
Yeah, it's coming down the wire.
Because
now.
We could both be 100% correct, but we need opposite results. So OptiNation versus TK, that game is currently 2-0 in favor of TK. Now, that's good for you because you had OptiNation in 7th, 8th.
Prediction, yeah.
That's terrible for me because I had TK 7th, 8th.
It's getting competitive.
But this game as well is also really important. This is going to be Denial going up against the wonderful Justice. Now,
well, there's one thing I want to talk about, point out before, just because I don't know if our viewers are aware of this. Justice is currently 14-1 in respawns. They are 0-6 in S&D.
Good job.
The fact that they're playing for top 6 and they haven't won an S&D yet is just absurd. That's what I thought OptiGaming was
So they've never had a game 5?
They've just been, dude, they haven't dropped the 14-1 respawn.
Yeah, that's
they're not making it past game 4.
That's
so
pretty
keep an eye out on this game too, because the S&D could be a big deciding factor if Justice continues what they've been doing.
Well, right now it's an early lead, 14-9. They have 17-1 on this first hill and trying to pull away. You see
Slack basically has the only kills right now.
I mean, yes, there is that. He is 6-2, and able with a really poor start of 1-4. Classic, of course, 0-4. Now, I was watching this Denial team earlier on. They played against AR, and they did not look good. They got taken to the cleaners in Hardpoint. It was pretty brutal, I'm not going to lie.
But what's nice for them, we talk about this, they got a bit of a warm-up, right?
Yes.
They got the gears rolling this morning, whereas Justice has yet to play, I believe, today, right?
This is Justice's first game. Yep.
So this game one, you know, that might favor his Denial squad a bit, the fact that they've got a series under their belt.
Chiller with the melee attack from behind. He's going to jump up top. There's going to be a player there. It's replays him. Moch actually just fell off the hill. That's never a good idea. Okay, that's definitely not what you want to see from Mochilla.
No, just very, completely very unaware of that player playing prone, not able to pick it up. Select, should get the call out, moves in as well. And who is, it's Replay, just laying there prone. No one able to get any shots in on this guy who's just going to sit here as the points tick away. We've got about 15 seconds until the next rotation is going to come in. 40-point advantage right now for our Denial crew. But wow, somehow Replay has managed to just lay there prone. Sneaky little beaver holds down the fort.
You know, this is just the Slack share right now for Justice. Everyone else really, really struggling on this team. Everyone negative. Enable 2-7. Classic 3-8. That is not what you want to see if you're a Justice fan. And now they're going to be on that hardpoint too. And considering how big Replay just went on this last hardpoint, I want to see. And also the rotations Denial are having, it's worth mentioning. Getting to these hardpoints first is just not good enough on your Justice. When you're only fighting for scrap time, you need to make sure you lock down a hardpoint.
Yeah, you know, we've talked some of these maps in the game, you know, that early, like, 20-second rotation favors you. Some you're able to rotate a little bit later. This is a map where I think, because a lot of these are inside buildings where you can get set up a little bit easier just watching, you know, an individual doorway, I think the early rotation does pay off a bit more. But Enable here, starting to heat up, able to pick up one kill, will eventually drop, but still it's coming down to the slang right now. Enable and Classic have got to get it going. But I'm going to be honest, I think this is mostly a slow start just due to the fact it's their first game. I think if this goes on, they're going to start rolling.
All right, well, we'll have to wait and see. Of course, still 7 minutes of game time still to play, 71-53. So you can see Justice are reducing that deficit. But now, the rotations. Let's have a look at our minimap, and you can see exactly who is rotating where. Have Slack's perspective on your screen right now. You see he's actually chasing down three players. Is he going to be able to get that in time? There's one. Can he find the second? Yes, he can. Slack, the man on a mission. Third's going to be in the left-hand side.
Slack, oh, my God,
three-piece, breaks the hill by himself. This guy's almost at 20 kills. This is 420, and wow. This is unbelievable. Slack is basically saying, guys,
okay,
it's cool. Don't worry. I know you only have 6 kills in Enable.
Zuma got to the hill first. He got 2 massive kills to give Denial control. Slack came in and said, all right, me versus 4 players? I'm going to kill every single one.
No!
Oh, dear God, the 6 streak.
This is unreal play from Slack right now. He is just putting the team in his backpack.
He's got 22. The next closest is 15. The next closest on his team is 11. And he's just continuing to cruise here. This is absurd.
This is fantastic from Slack. Finally goes down, but the damage has been done. And that is going to be Justice going into the lead for the first time in this game.
A
very slow start.
Gave them the lead.
But he can't. This isn't going to continue, though. That's the thing. This is not going to continue. You can't expect Slack to, you know, break a hard point by himself, take down 4 plays every hill.
That was almost embarrassing. As impressive as that was for him, it was almost embarrassing for Denial. You can't let that happen.
Yeah.
They had all 4 players complete control of that top green area, and he just came in and said, no,
oh,
this is my
Replays 3-piece. The Haymaker to Enable just shuts him down, and I think we're going to be in for a really good series.
Oh, yeah, this is going to be really back and forth. As soon as Justice gets firing at all cylinders, I mean, really, they're only in this game right now because they're riding on the back of Slack. We'll see replays here, trying to hold this yellow tunnel. Just peeking, shooting, getting a little pre-fire action. One's going to push him his right. The timing, they're going to catch him off, but he actually ends up pushing in. He gets one. Can he turn on this player? That was almost disgusting. His teammate helps him out. Eventually, he will drop in the lead. Back in the hands of Denial here, just over halfway through this one. Just under halfway, sorry.
18 kills for him. Zuma 17 and as well, Saint 17. So you can see the slaying power coming in from Denial. And that's the worrying thing. You know, Justice, it's pretty much the Slack show for them. They need some help, and Slack on the hill now is looking for the kill in the corner, not going to be able to get it. Zuma cleans up that one. Enable now pushing down to see if he can pick up some kills. 127, 101, still a very close game right now.
All right, we got this hill here at the Biolab. We'll see if they're going to be rotating out. The swarm coming in from both sides. You see several players flooding through tunnels. Saints will take up one. There was another player in the tunnel that is going to clean him up, but that was three down there, I believe, for your Atlas side, which is Justice. They can't get stuff rolling right now, but still, they're well within range.
Oh, I mean, yeah, it's, what, maybe 40 points it's about to be?
Yeah.
And the big thing for me is just how well Replace is playing. You know, his 17 kills, they're all on hills.
Oh, yeah.
He's just
yeah.
being that guy who's just causing so many issues. The Saints just jumping up and down. Again, being that pogo stick on the hard points, you see that a lot. That's just going to leave Mochilla by himself. And Denial controlling these first couple of hills so well on the hard point rotations.
Yeah, I got to think the Replace is leading the way when it comes to defense at this point. At least it certainly seems
that
way.
Gets one. Guy has seven defense, man.
He's got seven. Yeah, that makes sense. He's been, like you said, all his kills have been crucial. You know, we talk about how important KD is, but there is certainly a difference between important kills and less important kills, though just defense being some of the biggest.
Oh, without a doubt. But again, the rotation in favor of Denial, that's something that Justice just are failing miserably on in this hardpoint. They need to start rotating earlier because Denial are going to make them pay. Denial's a team of such quality that if you give them too much time, they'll just embarrass you.
And if they lose this game one, you know, after that stat I mentioned with the 14-1 in respawn for Justice and 0-6 in S&D.
That's really
you
bad.
You think if they lose this game, that's putting them in a bad, bad position. Possible down 0-2 here early on.
Yeah, that's not going to be good for them at all. Classic is on that hard point, though, for Justice. And, you know, in that first cycle of hard points, this is where we actually saw Justice kind of come back into it. It's the first couple which they really let themselves go. Now, though, rotation is going to be key. Hardpoint will be rotating very soon. You see Classic, he's going to be left on that hill. So let's have a look at someone fighting for the rotation. It's going to be Enable. There's a player in there. Enable doesn't see it. He goes down. That means Slacked. Last man up for Team Justice to try and break into that hardpoint. He's down. And you just see the fantastic play from Denial on how to hold this hill.
Yeah, they're going to get a lot of time here. You saw that you got the far spawn there. They're all going to be coming across here. They're going to have to win some gunfights. It looked like Attach got a team kill. Mochilla ended up getting one, so that's going to leave a little breathing room. They might be able to break this one. There's another kill for Moch. There's one to his left. Nice exo movement there, but couldn't get the shots on target. They busted into this one. Trying to get the shots on Attach. Can't clean it up. Can his teammate finish? Attach will be hop-skipping around outside, and the reload comes at a poor time. They might be able to break back in this. Big shots going. Classic, still alive somehow.
Huge.
He's been surviving in this corner this whole time, and they're trying.
Why would
you,
you do
joking?
That? Classic, really? That's noob mistake right there.
In hindsight, might
that.
Not have been the brightest.
And Saints is actually going to get tagged up from that through the wall, which is kind of amusing there. 179, 148, still a very, very close game. Denial do have the scrap time, but one player is actually pushing from Justice. Who is this? It's Mochilla. He just fell jumping through the door, but should be able to clean up one kill there. Does so. Now, this is where we saw Slack go absolutely massive last time for his team, and this time it's going to be down to Mochilla to try and defend that hill. Classic now left up alone. He's on the hill. Slack is there as well. So I'm on board with Slack. You have to be.
He got there. One, but that player from the left, Classic, couldn't win his gunfight. He actually got picked off by the player that Slack was able to clean up. But control here, going to go to Denial. If they get a good amount of time on this hill, they're going to put it away.
Yep, we'll see. Saints jumping up and down. He goes down. We'll have a look at replays. 25, 24, 10 caps. Attach 11 caps as well. This Denial team so solid. It's getting a little bit shaky though because we have 70 points left potential. And they're down by 40 points.
They should. If they hold this, they're going to get probably about what? About 20 more points.
Oh, Zuma.
These kills. That was big. They had to win that one. It's still contested right now. Slack's going to fall as well. Points going to come in. It looks like these last five ticks or so as we get the rotation are going to go to the side of Denial, but they're within about 30 right now. They've got plenty of time to do this, but this next one's going to be massive.
Yeah, you can see all the players trying to get set up and ready and waiting. Slack's going to leave that hill. 50 seconds left, so potential of 50 points, and it is going to be Justice on the hill right now. You got Enable and Classic. Mochilla, 33 kills. Slack, 36 kills. Enable is going to clean that up. However, the hard point is going to be contested, and Justice need these kills, and they need to get them quickly. because they can't afford to have it contested for so long right now. It's a 205 to 188, Maven. Enable just goes big, keeps the hardpoint under control. It is still contested, but they are picking up these kills. 26 seconds left. Can Justice do it?
I don't think so. Just because you can flood in this one, it's in such a central location, they can just keep contesting. They don't even need to get kills at this point. They just have to keep flooding in. With a couple more seconds here, it's going to put it away. 13, 12, that's it. They're not going to be able to come back in this. And that was played well by Denial. If this was a different hill, they might have been all right. But this one, you can just keep throwing bodies right at it. They contested just enough to put it out of reach.
Denial, such heads-up play, as you
said.
They
didn't win, like, any gunfights in there. They right. just dove in
just run.
And
just
tried
keep
to
running,
contest.
Keep running, yeah. waste time. And, well, Maeve, coming back to that stat that you mentioned at the very beginning.
That this is scary if you're Justice.
Yes, this is,
God,
this is
you know, scary. I blame Puppet. I blame Puppet for this.
You blame Puppet? Why is this Puppet?
Some way, somehow, this is Puckett's fault. And I only care, you know, I love Denial, I love Justice. I'm only rooting for Justice a little bit because of my bracket. that's about it at this
yes.
point. But fantastic game number one. Came down to the final hill there. And again, Justice, 14-1 in respawns, 0-6 in S&D. Going into a game two S&D down 0-1, that's scary, Ben.
Yeah, that's not a stat I want to hear when I'm looking at my predictions.
No.
Thank you for that, by the way. You made me feel very unnervy, but who knows?
I went to Moch's Twitter. You know, I'm a Twitter guy. I'll sit here.
That's interesting because Moch and Enable, very talented at searching.
Well, when I saw it, I was like, "Are you that? What?" Because I feel like I remember watching them play online, and they're pretty confident.
They were very good at searching Destroy online.
Moch and Ghost, known to be one of the best, and
struggling.
But anyway, let's take a look. We're around five, correct? Yeah, so Search and Destroy Recovery will be the next map. Let's see if Justice can go against all odds and win their first S&D of the weekend. Quick commercial break, tweet the stream. We'll be right back.